Hey there, and welcome to your AMCEntertainment.com. My name is John Campia. I'm the senior editor of Script to Screen. And today I'm really excited to be joined by not only a great up-and-coming actor who's starring in what all my friends are telling me is an incredible film, but he's also a fellow Canadian. I want to introduce you, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Shawn Ashmore. Shawn, how you doing?
John, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Hey, listen. Before I get into anything else, for those people who know nothing about Frozen yet, tell us about this project.
Well, Frozen is a film written and directed by a guy named Adam Green, who's a really talented guy. And, you know, basically the film, in broad strokes, is three people get stranded on a Sunday night on a chairlift 50 feet above the ground at a resort that closes Sundays and opens Fridays. And so they're basically stuck there for 5 days, and it's a story about how these people try to survive, how they cope in the elements, and sort of how they all sort of unwind when sort of put in the elements and then have to deal with their primal fears. You know, the film really draws on, you know, fear of heights, fear of isolation, you know, fear of, those are the key elements, and it's really just about what happens to these people over the several days that they're stuck up on this lift.
Now, you mentioned Adam Green, and Adam directed one of my absolute favorite fun horror films of the last 10 years, which was Hatchet. Yes. What's it like working with Adam?
Well, honestly, Adam is one of the most creative guys that I've ever worked with. He's got this, you know, I think he's known as from Hatchet and things like that, where it's, you know, it's really about, like, you know, gruesome deaths and with a really dark sense of humor. But he's really, really one of the nicest guys I've ever worked with. Very interesting, very deep guy. A lot of the writing for Frozen, you know, when I heard the pitch of the movie, I thought interesting, because I'm a snowboarder. I grew up snowboarding, and everybody that has ever been on a lift, whenever that lift stops and starts to swing, you get that pit in your stomach. You're like, oh wow, okay, is this going to stop? Are we going to fall? What's happening? And even if you're only stopped for 2 minutes, it feels like a half hour. You know what I mean? There is something that is terrifying about being stranded on this piece of equipment. But the thing that really pulled me in, I mean, the idea itself, I was like, okay, I get it. I know where they're going. I know what this movie could be. But, you know, Adam is really, really incredible with dialogue and really, really amazing at character development, which is, for a film like this, where essentially you only have three characters on one location for an hour and a half, you need to be interested in these people. You need to understand them. You need to see into them. You need to have great arcs. You need to be able to find your way into them, too. It can't be obvious, you know. And Adam really crafted three interesting characters, put in an extraordinary situation, and sort of allows it to play out. So it was, you know, Adam's a great guy. I think he's really smart, really talented, and I was just impressed with how prepared he was in making this film and the characters that he actually gave us to play, and his openness to allow us to sort of, you know, be creative with these characters. Because, again, as an actor, this is a huge gift to be given a character like this and to be given the time to develop it, but you also have to feel like you own these characters. You can't just always play what's on the page, because, you know, as soon as there's a false beat in a movie like this where you can't cut away to a set piece or there isn't, you know, a million other characters to cut to, as soon as there's a false beat with these characters, the audience is taken out of it. So that was something we were very aware of trying to be as real as possible and as true to, you know, to who these people would be and what would actually happen in these situations. So Adam is an amazing guy, and I look forward to hopefully working with him again, but also I'm always excited to see what he has up his sleeve and what he's going to be doing next.
Now, you know, I could never appear in a film like Frozen for two very important reasons. Number one, I can't act. And the second reason is I have a terrifying fear of heights. And, you know, I'm watching the trailer for this film, and you know, a friend of mine and I were discussing that the things that feel more real in films are the things that terrify you most. You know, I can watch Avatar and watch this giant tiger creature chase Jake through the jungle and think,
right,
oh, wow, he's in trouble. I see this ski lift stop in this trailer and my heart is pounding through my chest. What, like, how often or how much time did you actually have to spend suspended above the ground sitting in this ski lift?
Let me say this first of all. I think the trailer is great. But by watching the trailer, you haven't seen anything. Just wait. So let me put it that way, because I think there's a couple shots in there that are absolutely terrifying. And just after having seen the movie, I'm like, you ain't seen nothing yet. Just wait. So that's exciting to know that you're getting your reaction from the trailer, like what it's going to be like when you're actually sitting in a giant theater. But we spent basically 20 something days up on the lift. on a real location. That was one thing that Adam really wanted to do, shoot this movie practically. I think he took the idea to a lot of different people, and they're very interested in the story, but they said, you know, let's put this on a green screen on a set so we can control it and insurance purposes and all that stuff. And, you know, Adam was very adamant about making a survival film like this, a thriller like this, in the real elements, and difficult. We had three blizzards while we were shooting. Kevin Zegers, Emma Bell, and I were up on the lift for 12 hours a day for 22 days or something like that. Yeah,
wow.
At 9,000 feet in Utah in minus 19 degree weather. I mean, it was the crappy thing about it is clearly it was a very physically demanding, difficult shoot. I mean, there's no doubt it was miserable some days. And like, I don't say that in any way trying to be disparaging about the production, but we all knew exactly what we were getting into. Adam told us, he's like, this will probably be the most difficult project any of us ever work on. And that was absolutely true. There's no doubt.
Well, right now, what we are excited about is Frozen. Thank you again, Shawn, for taking the time to join us here. Congratulations on Frozen. We're really looking forward to it. And we hope you join us again here on Script to Screen.
Awesome. I can't wait, man. Enjoy it. It's going to be fun.
All right. Take care.